According to the blood patterns, that's where the victim was attacked. So that must be the killer's trail. It's locked. At last, a little life.
Welcome, sir, to the Turquoise Turtle.
It's a good thing you cannot see me now, Mum.
God, sir, you look like Jonah's whale just spat you out of hell. Can I get you a drink?
No, thank you. I'm not thirsty.
Well, grab a chair and get some rest. This is gonna be another long night.
Why is it going to be a long night?
You must be new around here. Don't you know about the murders?
Do the police have any leads on a suspect?
Even before the outbreak, coppers never came round here. We're on our own. People die in these parts all the time, and no one cares.
Tell me more about these murders.
Every morning for the last few weeks, bodies have been found. And those poor sods didn't die of flu.
Where am I? Where is this place?
You're at my bar, sir, the Turquoise Turtle. The last ray of light in this dangerous part of town.
So you're open all night?
Yep. Figured people might need a place to rest in these dark times.
Aren't you scared?
Scared of what? All the bad shit happens out on the foggy streets. And I never go outside.
I'm looking for someone who might have passed through here recently. Wondered if you might help.
It's been quiet tonight. The only other person I've seen went straight up to his room. Thought it was kind of rude, actually.
You mean he's still here?
Well, yeah. He paid for the entire week.
this man? What does he look like?
Well, like a gentleman, I guess. Well dressed, quite polite. A professor or something fancy like that. Always writing, reading notes.
How long has he been here?
He rented the room a few days ago and didn't say when he'd leave.
I need to meet this man. I have questions.
Just climb the stairs and knock on the first door. I heard him open his window, so I guess he's still awake. And,
Yes?
No funny business, you hear me? This is a respectable establishment.
Good evening, sir. I wondered if I could ask for your help.
Wow, you look like you need a drink.
Yes. I apologize for my outfit. It's been a long night.
Been there, seen that. Don't worry, things can only get worse.
Has anybody entered the bar recently?
Can't say. Sorry. I spent the night making love to that gorgeous bottle, see?
This is important, sir. Are you sure no one has come in here in the last few hours?
I don't know and I don't care. This is a free country. People still have the right to come and go, don't they?
What's going on around here? It's like everybody is hiding.
You must be new here. Have you not heard about the murders? Everybody fears the return of the sewer dog.
Who is this sewer dog?
It's a local bogeyman. Convenient answer for every crime that happened for decades. You murdered someone. Blame the sewer dog, eh?
You make it sound like it's a fairy tale.
People will always believe in monsters. It's easier than accepting their own darkness. We can all be monsters.
I'll leave you to your bottle then.
Hello, sir. Are you all right? Is there any way I can help you?
I don't know. Maybe you could just talk to me.
Maybe you prefer to speak with Tom, then. He's more agreeable talking to strangers.
I just want to talk. I didn't mean to scare you.
I'm not afraid, sir. It's just I've other customers to take care of.
I only see one customer.
Oh. Well, yeah, of course. I mean, I best check on them.
What's going on around here? Where is everyone?
Too many dead, sir. First the epidemic, and now all these terrible murders.
The murders? What can you say about them?
Bodies found in the streets every morning. Drained of blood. It's just horrible. Some say the sewer dog is back.
The sewer dog? What's that?
No one knows. People have always disappeared around these parts. The ancients say it's the sewer dog coming out to feed. But now he's killing in the streets.
What have you heard about the epidemic?
It's a Spanish flu. Yeah. Killed so many last summer. Thought we'd seen the last of it. Dozens dying every week.
Are the authorities doing anything?
Nothing. There are so many quarantine zones in London now. It's gotten really hard to travel across town.
What is this place?
This is Tom's Bar, the Turquoise Turtle. I'm the barmaid here, Sabrina, if you want to know.
Are you always open this late at night?
No, it's only since the epidemic started. Tom thought that people may need a safe place to stay.
You don't seem to have much business. Where is everybody?
Well, most people are sleeping right now. And those that are awake tend to avoid going out. What with the murders and all.
I'll leave then. Thank you.
There's gotta be something can be done to get out of this bullshit mess. No.
Are they stupid or something?
This is no place for you. Prewen has several patrols roaming the area.
They do not pursue me.
But they're looking for vampires. And they're most efficient.
They'll not relent until the killer has been identified.
I have a common objective, but I require...
Shh. I think someone is eavesdropping.
Are you certain? You might as well come in, whoever you are.
Slowly, vampire! Who are you?
I mean you no harm,
saith the vampire. Present yourself!
I need a word. Would anyone?
Oh. Well, that's something I can do for you.
And who might you be?
I'm not sure that I know anymore.
Might I at least learn the reason of your presence?
That's none of your concern.
Sir, you have entered my room in the middle of the night, pale as a corpse and shaking like a tree. So please, indulge me.
Someone is molesting people. In fact, killing them. Biting them.
The calling card of a vampire. Like you.
I've been hunted down in the streets and attacked. I'm a victim here, too.
I believe you.
Then if you are not a vampire, who or what are you?
Dr. Edgar Swansea of the Brotherhood of St. Paul. I'm performing an independent investigation here in an attempt to understand precisely what is going on.
What have you uncovered concerning the murders?
It started a few nights ago. Rumors of violent murders. The docks have always been, shall we say, somewhat unsavory. But this is different.
How different?
A vampire is at work here. Famished. Reckless. It must be brought to ground, and quickly.
I heard another voice, that of a woman. Who were you talking to?
Ridiculous. I have no idea what you're talking about.
Something tells me not to trust you.
Then the feeling is mutual.
And what exactly is this Brotherhood?
Sir, if the name is not familiar to you, then we shall discuss it another time.
Then help me find the culprit.
I may. If you'll first tell me why you opened this door.
I followed a trail. The scent of blood from a recent victim. It led me here.
You thought I was your aggressor. That explains a great deal. We're both chasing the same shadow.
Perhaps. This is all new to me. I'm not even certain what I'm looking for.
You should let me handle this affair. You've no idea what you're up against.
No. I will find the monster. He is mine.
How will you do any better than I? But then let me ask you this. What are your intentions if you find the killer?
I will at last have the answers to my questions.
Then I can only wish you good hunting. And pray we shall meet again. Would you be so kind as to leave the room?
I cannot enter.
It's a good thing you cannot see.
I think I'm losing my mind. I should just.
If Swansea is not my attacker, it means somebody else came here tonight. Someone must know something.
I hope I live long enough to see them where boot boys get what's coming to them.
I will get to the bottom of this intrigue. What's been done to me, to this city. It's locked. There's nobody here.
Evening, sir. Can I help you?
I have a few questions for you.
Well, if you must.
I spoke to Dr. Swansea. He's not the man I'm looking for. Now, I want the truth.
The truth? What do you mean?
I suspect that someone else was here tonight. And I don't think Tom wants to tell me about it.
I'm just the barmaid here, okay? If Tom says you're the only visitor we had, then you're the only visitor we had.
I can feel your fear, madam. Please, tell me what's going on.
It's Will. William Bishop. He came in here earlier tonight and he... Well, I thought he was going to clock someone.
Why are you so afraid?
I mean his skin. His hands. I scrubbed every glass and every chair that he touched. God, I hope it's not contagious.
What happened tonight?
He was dead drunk, as usual. But my God, his eyes. His face. He must have caught something awful. He shouted and cried. It was terrible.
Tell me about this William Bishop.
Will was a sailor who worked at the cannon factory before he lost that job. A nice bloke, really. He's never been violent. Until tonight.
Why keep it a secret? Why not tell me about it?
Tom's nothing if not loyal. After Will lost his job, he offered him one ear. They used to be good mates. But recently, Will started to get very aggressive.
I see. Thank you for your candor. I'll be sure to talk to Tom.
Welcome back. Did you find what you were after?
I can't say I have. Are you sure no one else came into your bar before I arrived?
Hey, I told you, you were the only other stranger I've had.
To me about the visit from your old friend William.
Yes, Will came by tonight, but he's not my friend anymore.
Why lie to me if he is not your friend?
I didn't lie. I said you were my only unannounced customer, and that's the truth.
Who is he?
William. Just an old sailor who loves his gin too much. He worked for years at the cannon factory before it closed.
Is he dangerous?
Yeah. Like many drunks, he's all bark and no bite. He can barely stand up most of the time.
How was he tonight? Was he different?
Sicker than usual, perhaps. He whined and mumbled about how mean people were to him and how he'd like to talk to me outside, and then he left when I refused.
I need to find him. It's a matter of urgency. Do you know where he is?
You could try his boat. It's up by the North Pier. He sleeps there when he's too drunk to get home.
Please describe him to me.
What'd you expect? He's a tall, sick bastard with a bad rash and torn old clothes. William used to be strong, now he's a mess.
Thank you, Tom.
If you see him, tell him I don't want him back here unless he cleans up his act, okay?
body is still warm. This man has just been drained of blood. What's this? Some sort of note. This man was armed. He tried to defend himself. This corpse has been dried of its blood, just like the previous victim. Blood and empty gin bottles. This Bishop fellow is something of a heavy drinker. There are blood splats on the other side of the canal. I must reach that barge. Ammunition crate. Good. I may need a lot of bullets. I feel like I'm back on the front line again.
Shut that foolish man, please. Never know McCullum to be wrong about anything.
Right. No time up for him, man. Thank you.
Step away, sir.
Crush the leech, boys!
Does it, boys? We can deal with this first.
Stay back, sir.
Fresh blood. The whole building reeks of it. The scent is so strong it makes me dizzy.
One we shall overcome.
This place reeks of bloodshed.
William, please stop.
Just a sip.
This creature is bedeviled. I must put it down.
William was an honorable man. I could have saved him.
Mr. Hampton, are you in there?
We knew him well, another lost soul, a kindred spirit.
Sir, listen to the sound of my voice. I'm a doctor. You're suffering from shock.
I must return to my flock. They'll stray without me.
Remember, certain Skulls are every bit as resistant as we are. Who are you? What do you mean by Skal?
You truly are a newborn. I should have realized.
Wait. You are the woman from the bar. Are you like me? Can you help me?
I believe, sir, I already have.
George and the Saints, you've solved the mystery of these terrible murders. Patience, good fellows, I've come to offer help. Just give me a moment to secure my boat. We can leave this awful place.
William was not the evil man they claimed. He was just taken by the thirst. He needed his drink.
This man requires medical attention. We'll see he gets to the nearest hospital.
No, please, I almost tend to my fold. My flock needs me.
Yes. Go with the good Dr. Swansea. He's resourceful, and I'm sure he'll take good care of you.
You'd best come as well. The sun is soon to rise, and you'll need a place to rest.
I just need a moment. If I can learn something about what has happened to William, I'll be a step closer to understanding what happened to me. This poor creature can't be my maker. Could it be some sub-species of vampire? I must find a place to analyze the blood.
Where are we headed?
We're on our way to the Pembroke Hospital. It's just across the canal. They'll have a bed for poor Mr. Hampton.
William was... What manner of creature was he?
Predator, prey, villain, and victim. Who can say? The important thing is that he's been stopped.
Duly noted. And the woman? What... Who is she?
What woman?
Oh, don't play me for a fool. You used me to locate that... Skal, you must know who she is.
And I thought you a gentleman. You shouldn't talk about a lady behind her back, but I will tell you she values her privacy. Were London as peaceful as she appears from the middle of the canal? If only that were the reality of the situation.
To be honest, I've always tried to avoid this part of town.
Pembroke Hospital is the last bastion between the rest of London and the epidemic. The flu has decimated the East End, and the war still rages. Welcome to the front lines of a plague.
This is where you work, Dr. Swansea.
I am the administrator of Pembroke Hospital.
I thought you were here in service of your mysterious order, the Brotherhood of...
Of St. Paul's Stone, yes. But first and foremost, I'm a man of science. A physician, like yourself, Dr. Reed.
How do you know who I am?
No need for modesty. You are Dr. Jonathan Reed. A surgeon of some caliber and renown, if I'm not mistaken.
You are correct, sir.
I knew it! I had my suspicions. But when you took the blood sample from the corpse of poor William, I was certain. Dr. Reed. Marvelous.
Have we met?
I attended 3 of your seminars before the war. I have the utmost admiration for your research. And what a turn of fate. England's most esteemed blood specialist returns to London a vampire.
That word, again, from a so-called man of science.
I understand. Traditionally, the role of science is to refute myth, but when myth walks among us? The Brotherhood of St. Paul has dedicated its purpose to their study. There's so much for you to learn.
Of that, you are right.
Well, then let me be blunt. Join my staff at Pembroke Hospital. As a physician. I suspect you'll not find a better post of employment to contemplate your predicament.
This is sudden. I was returning home to see my sickly mother. But alas, that was before contracting this affliction.
Dr. Reed, take a moment to consider. The post would be for the night shift, providing a good explanation for your absence during daylight hours. You'll be adequately reimbursed and have a place to hide. I even had the forethought to bring some clean clothes. So, what do you say?
It seems I have little choice, but yours is a generous offer, so I thank you.
Brilliant! Oh, Jonathan, this is one for the book, and the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Dr. Swansea, thank goodness. I was beginning to be concerned.
Worry no more, Nurse Crane, for I bring good news.
Oh, Doctor, what a night. We lost 2 more patients. Nurse Scow said she couldn't take it anymore and resigned.
Yes, well, I'll make a new rotor in the morning. In the meantime, find a good bed for Mr. Hampton. Be sure to pay attention to his needs.
Of course, Doctor.
Oh, and Dorothy?
Yes, Doctor?
Dr. Reed here has just returned from the front. He served King and Country and will be joining us here at Pembroke. We're very lucky to have gained a surgeon of his talent and one so experienced in blood transfusions.
That is good news indeed, Doctor.
Oh, yes. Here at Pembroke, it's not what we have, but what we haven't. It's only thanks to Nurse Crane and the staff that our ship doesn't sink. If you have any questions, just ask her.
Duly noted. Thank you.
Your assistance is required, Dr. Swansea, immediately.
Welcome aboard, Jonathan. We'll catch up after my rounds. Coming, Nurse Crane. I'm coming.
Come on, you bastard! I won't bite!
Sir, please! You've lost too much blood. Calm yourself.
You think I didn't notice? Stop your staring and get me to an hospital, you arse!
Insulting a good Samaritan. Not exactly the way to get rescued.
All right, sorry. I am in pain here. My guts are spilling out onto the street and you're yabbering on.
Yes. That's a very nasty wound you've got there. Take my word, I am a doctor, Dr. Jonathan Reed.
Name's Clay Cox. I'd appreciate you helping me to a better place, Doc.
Follow me, Mr. Cox. Let me assist you to that better place. No more. Not tonight. Not like this. I will not take another life.
What? What happened? Whoa, I feel giddy.
It is wise for the huntsman to sometimes let his prey go, but no famished hunter can run for long.
Good evening, nurse. I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed, the new surgeon here at the Pembroke.
Dr. Swansea has already told us about you, sir. I'm Nurse Gwyneth Branigan. Welcome to the Pembroke Hospital.
Did he really? It's a good thing I wasn't hoping to keep a low profile.
All members of staff have already read about your new blood transfusion technique. Dr. Swansea made sure of that.
I see. Well, I'm a little surprised. But I suppose I'll just have to deal with this unexpected notoriety.
You must know, blood transfusions are Dr. Swansea's primary subject of research. He is convinced it is the future.
How are things here?
Not good, to say the least. We're struggling against an invisible enemy, more lethal than any bullet from a gun. It's hard, Doctor.
An invisible enemy. Quite a poetic term for a disease, especially from a nurse.
Sorry, Doctor. These last few weeks have been exhausting. We could all do with a good night's sleep.
Do you think this hospital can survive the epidemic?
We are all volunteers here, and we're trying to hold fast, but... how do we beat an invisible killer? Some nurses have already resigned.
I'm not familiar with all the staff yet. Perhaps you could help me.
Brilliant professionals, most of them. Dr. Swansea has a gift for recruiting talent.
Most of them?
Is there a problem?
I should know about, nurse.
It would be inappropriate for me to speak ill of a colleague.
Is there anyone that stands out?
Well, I have never met someone as dedicated as Dr. Tippett. He should be a standard for us all here. If only he were younger.
Why should his age be a problem?
I guess it's fair to say he's always pushing himself to the limits. He just doesn't know when to stop and get some rest.
Goodbye, nurse. Call me if you need assistance.
Doctor, where have you been? I've little time to play hide-and-seek with new staff members, no matter how illustrious they may be.
I found a wounded man by the docks. He answers to the name of Clay Cox. He requires urgent medical attention.
Already making the rounds? That's the Pembroke spirit. I'll ask our porter, Milton, to bring him back immediately.
Thank you, nurse. What can I do for you?
Dr. Swansea insisted we provide you a quiet office. You'll find it on the second floor with your name on the door.
Thank you. Nurse Crane, isn't it?
Yes, Dorothy Crane. Welcome to Pembroke Hospital, Dr. Reed. Your office has been prepared.
I would like to ask a few questions first. And Mr. Hampton, the patient we brought in, how does he fare?
I gave him a sedative to help him sleep. Poor thing was in quite a state of shock.
What kind of man is Dr. Swansea?
Well, you accepted the job from him. I thought you would have known about your employer.
It's right to assume Dr. Swansea knows far more about me than I do about him.
You'll get to know him soon enough, and better than me. The administrator has better things to do than mix with us.
If you could point me in the direction of my room again, nurse.
Second floor of the hospital, left after the stairs. It's the last vacant office at the end of the corridor.
Thank you, Nurse Crane. Good evening, sir.
So it is true. The famous Dr. Reed has joined us. I can't think of any better news during these terrible times.
Do we know each other?
Actually, yes. We met once before at the Rockefeller University in New York.
Dr. Tippett's, yes, I remember. I was assisting Professor Carell in his research about coronary bypasses. He had nothing but praise for you.
He was also very confident about your future. And look at you now. Eminent surgeon and blood transfusion specialist.
You're exhausting yourself, Corcoran. Maybe you should think about preserving your strength.
No. We must keep on healing all those poor souls. We are the last rampart before chaos. Once more, unto the breach.
Nurse Branigan is worried about you, Doctor.
She should not have told you that. I will have a word with her.
You don't have to blame her for her honesty.
I'm not that kind of man, my dear Jonathan. Actually, Nurse Branigan's opinion is the only one I may listen to.
What is the Pembroke Hospital situation? And please, Speak freely.
This hospital is not exactly the best of London. I'm sure you are used to working in a better environment.
It's more than enough. In any case, the personnel of a hospital are much more important to me than the building.
Don't be misled by appearances, Dr. Reed. This hospital does not lack talented people. It just lacks hope.
What can you tell me about the staff in the hospital?
Some are really good, and others are not so good. But during this troubled period, there is no time for slander. I prefer to focus on the positive character traits.
Tell me more about cherished people, then.
Nurse Branigan is a pearl. She is the most helpful and dedicated nurse I've ever worked with. A clever and cheerful woman.
You really seem to admire her skills.
I'll go even further. If she was a man, she would be a damn fine practitioner.
Any opinion about the management?
I don't always agree with Dr. Swansea's reserve, but I must admit he does all he can to keep this facility running during this crisis.
Ah, yes, the burden of command. I was fed up with this concept while serving as a medical officer.
Don't get me wrong. Swansea's a good administrator. I just wish he would get out of his office down again.
Goodbye, Dr. Tibbetts. Good evening, sir. I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed. I'm new here.
I've already heard about you, Dr. Reed. I'm Milton Hooks, the ambulance driver for this shithole of a hospital.
That's quite a blunt introduction, Mr. Hooks.
You can call me Milton. I like to speak my mind, Dr. Reed. Perk of the job. Don't judge me, and I won't judge you.
I'm not sure I understand what you're talking about.
Well, I'm no doctor, but I'm pretty sure a gun can't be used as a surgical instrument.
You have a keen eye. I learned to shoot during the war, and have carried one ever since. Old habits die hard.
No need to explain, Dr. Reed. And if you ever need a better gun, remember, I may have something for you.
I'd like to see your goods.
Wise choice, Dr. Reed. A reliable gun is what everybody needs these days. Last summer's epidemic was difficult.
Dr. Swansea is right. This place seems perfect to conduct my research. This must be the place. It's definitely away from prying eyes. Relegated to the shadows. A kingdom of my own. At least I won't be sleeping in a coffin. William Bishop's blood is much more unstable than human blood, and the sun is about to rise. I can feel it. I'll continue tomorrow night.